What's up, everybody, and welcome to ESO Daily. I am your host, Mystic Raven. All right, guys. So yesterday ended the anniversary cake, so it's just back to a normal shit up until Morrowind comes out. I'm still kind of anticipating like a patch somewhere, along the line somewhere. I may be wrong, but I'm anticipating it. Anyways, guys. So, currently my champion's at 333. We're looking at the dailies being Elden Hollow 2, Cradle of Shadows, and Vallenfell, I believe. Yeah, it's Vallenfell, though. I know it is. Right there it is. All right, so we're gonna queue up the random. So, vet. Once again, trying to knock two birds out with one stone. Hopefully. That'd be nice. Hopefully. I'm hoping. Really, really. I didn't quite finish my Stamps Orc. He's almost done. Trying to get him done, and another. I got two dagger, three Daggerfall characters. Crypt of Hearts one. That was yesterday's. Shit. Really? Come on, man. This happened to me last time. Boss. I can't catch a break, man. It's 50-50 on some shit. Damn. Anyways, so one of my real life friends, he plays Daggerfall, and I have EP typically, but he's heavy PvP-er, so I'm rolling up a few Daggerfall characters to PvP with him. So in the near future. Looking forward to it. It's different when I'm in Citadel, but it is what it is. If you're not on my side, you're dead. And I got my DK. My DK is on Daggerfall. My DK healer. I got plans for that dude. Believe you and me. I love DK healing in PvP. I love it. It possibly I don't know if I like it as much as my Nightblade, but make no doubt about it. I love my DK healer in PvP. The shit I do is ridiculous. Love it. And I got big plans for him when Morrowind and Battlegrounds come out every day of the week. Still trying to get. I need two completely different setups for him. Because for PvP, you have to run an entire different kind of scenario. You can, like, I'll probably use the same base set. Not saying that'll probably change, but my secondary sets and my monster set changes, based on what he's needing or what's missing. But I'm trying to put together a nice solid DK healer that can benefit party members, but definitely give the advantage to small team play. That's kind of where I'm going with it, Really offering some of those mitigating high-end mitigating effects and CC and increase to my party members. Kind of where I'm going with it. I'm looking forward to it personally. Prosperous, yeah. So yeah, I'm gonna be working on some keys, getting him geared up, getting everything situated as much as possible. It was funny, because this player yesterday was like, your builds suck. And I'm like, really? Because I don't see a lot of DK, Nightblade, Sork healers running these vets on random. You know, vet randoms. I do it all the time. I don't give a shit. Like, really? Okay, whatever. You know, proof's in the pudding, people. Whatever. Every day of the week. Dude, why? You know, sometimes proc effects just amaze me. Ugh. Divine? Really? I had this conversation because somebody had asked me, you know, you were mentioning diminishing return on gear. And I'm like, yeah, you know, diminishing return just doesn't affect CP. That's not the case. Gear has a diminishing effect as well. Not as dramatic. You wouldn't notice it. You wouldn't really notice it unless you're paying attention. But like, I usually go the three biggest infused on my gear for a reason, typically. But sorcerer, I it's not always the case. Sorcerer, if I'm running the thief, I will run that extra divine to you know, get my percentage up there to about 50, as close as 55 point something, as much as possible, as much as possible. Because you need that extra divine piece to do it, but the DR after that isn't worth it, considering, you know. So, and then like on my DK, he has an opposite effect where he suffers max stat. So instead of running as many divine on him, I'll go with one more piece of infused. So. To maximize more on his max magicka and PvE. PvP, man, I got a whole different setups on those builds. You know. I gotta fix this. Something keeps happening to my FTC where it's not high. It's supposed to, like, when you engage in combat, it's supposed to throw up their life and shit. And for some reason, it's not. So I'm gonna reset it and have to dick with that today. Add-ons can be a blessing, but at the same time, when they bug up and, right, like, it's supposed to do it like that, but hey, man, whatever. First time I've ever seen a DPS with barrier. Not happening. Oh, that's bad. Dude, that's so weird. That was just weird. Leviathan, okay. I definitely want to talk about Leviathan set here. Okay, on my Stam Sorc, I don't use Leviathan. You know, I'd rather take Tooth Throw, reason being Major Savagery. Very important for Stam Sorc if you're going to run a build and you're needing if you're needing crit set, if you're needing it. But Leviathan, I wouldn't use on my Stam Sorc, you know. So, because I use Bound Armament and on the Stam Sorc, where I would rather not use Camouflage Hunter. But Leviathan is good for all the other DPS versus the Tooth Throw, because you can slot, if needed, you can slot the Camouflage Hunter and increase your weapon damage. Stam Sorcs already get a nice amount of weapon damage for their sorcerer ability slotted and their passive. Leviathan is definitely not as beneficial for the Stam Sorc, but it definitely has its applications. I know there's shit there, guys. Can we just please get it after? I'm in this dungeon. I really don't want to be in here. I just want to hurry up. Infused Leviathan. Well, that would have been awesome if it would have been divine. And there's my heavy sack. Yo. I'm trying to play catch up here, guys, on this platform. You know, PC, you know, I have so many things going on with PS4. And I don't know if I'll ever... I imagine sometime I will, you know, get as many as I do on PS4, but PS4 currently is my main platform. Becomes a question, which platform will I start Battlegrounds on? So hard. On the opening week, I'm not going to work on my Warden. It's just not going to happen. I'm going to be in Battlegrounds. I am going to be in Battlegrounds that entire opening week. Believe you and me. I take Battleground PvP serious. I Battlegrounds to me it's been my bread and butter for years in play. Most MMOs I played always had a BG system of some sort. So I'm personally looking really forward to Battlegrounds. That's what I'm into. PS4, I was kind of looking forward to, because there's just a couple players I really want to, you know, get. I'm hoping to see in the BGs when it drops down. You know, I want to see how well some of these players adapt to a game system they may never have played before. And it's going to be a new twist with the 4v4, for sure. Not saying it won't be. But you can't really sit there and anticipate the same kind of results, because you know, it's a whole new, another beast. Red, what the hell? Unless you want to get firestormed or some shit. Does it? Oh my god. Oh shit. That's gonna be our problem here. Okay. Keep him out of that middle, man. When I did this last time, and you guys weren't actually able to watch it, when he was doing the explosion back, It was causing problems for the group. You know, a lot of people would just end up getting wrecked like that. Personally, I like taking them down both together at the same time. You know, kind of whittling them both down. This way you don't get one who's enraged, just maybe for a split second. You know, just switch back and forth. Technically, you can do that. It's how you're supposed to do it, but... the devs ever amped up the enrage effect on one of them for dropping the other one, players might catch on, but personally I'd look forward to it. I need something to keep me from getting bored doing some of this shit. I got ya. Oh, no, I do not. Yo, man, stop DPSing and get the dude up. Thank you. You know, Lambrinth set drops in here. I use Lambrinth on a couple of builds on certain things. Grothdar, I love it because I PvP'd over the weekend. You know, I love predictability because the only time I will ever die to that set is if someone hits that and Eye of the Storm at the same time. Other than that, I've never died to a Grothdar proc. Never. Not fucking ever. By itself. It's never fucking happened. Why? Because I can anticipate that stupid shit. And when somebody does that, I'm usually like, you know, banked up on my ulti. So all of a sudden, they'll go ahead and proc it. When they proc it, I'll sit back and I'll usually use an ultimate that has a stun effect or a CC. So all of a sudden, it'll go ahead, boom, and they're stunned, right? And it's just sitting there just... You know, the proc wears off. They got a couple of seconds before it'll reproc again. That's enough time to usually take them out and, you know, play cleanup if you have to. The stack Grothdar, that can hurt, you know, definitely. One piece of advice I'd give anybody who's PvP currently, drain poisons. Okay, I use drain poisons. I'm not going to lie. On certain builds, I do. Not every build. I use drain poisons. There's reasons for each build and why I do it. But I'm aware of drain poisons. I was one of the first people who said, if you're not using this triple dot drain, it's crazy. Because I used to use it with charged weapon. So I could always, guarantee the application. Because it's a status effect. Putting poison's a status effect. And when I know that a lot of people are going to hit me with that drain, right? And I l use a lot of heavy attacks and weaves now. So I'll give my viewers that heads up. Because it's not necessarily to recoup, but when you are bottomed out, right? It's very important to understand what your heavy attacks are going to do for you now, in any weapon. So I always tell people when you bottom out, that's where you need something specific like your heavy attacks. A lot of options too. So if you're a person who's usually dependent on sustain, like for life, if you're looking for self-sustains in PvP, and when you bottom out, you don't have that. That's what kind of another reason I like degeneration at times, because I'll slot the degeneration and I'll do my attacks, light and heavy attacks, and that usually will sustain me enough to recoup Magicka until the dot effect wears off. Because healers, if I'll be honest, I'll target healers if I'm running it. Specifically, if I have one of my builds that I'm running the drain, I will go ahead and I will target healers. It's always the first target for me. So, and I think once again, Fang made a good point because in Battlegrounds, even with no CP, you don't think people aren't going to use those debuffs? They are. I'm going to. I'm not going to lie to you guys. On certain builds, I'm going to be running debuffs, and poisons is part of that system. So the only thing I can tell you guys to do is be ready to counter, with your build. You can counter it. You can. There are ways around it, but the problem of it is it slows down your DPS. You've bottomed out. You have no resources. You'll be able to push out one or two or three abilities, but depending on the scenario, you might not be taking anybody out during that time. So you have to still keep in play and not let that effect take you out of the gameplay. Stealthers, I'm always telling people, stealthing in Battlegrounds has its function, but it's definitely not as effective in Battlegrounds as it is in Citadel. Citadel, you have a wider range, you can be a lot more effective in stealth techniques. Battlegrounds, you're going to be exposed faster, and once you're exposed, you're not going to be able to just go ahead and keep stealthing. They're going to use, it's going to be a shorter area. So once you're exposed, they know where to throw the caltraps. They know where to go ahead and run it. There was one guy who tried to stealth on me, but it didn't matter because as soon as he stealthed, I dropped the ultimate. I didn't, he was gone. He was completely out of my range, but the ultimate still allowed me to go ahead, jump, on my dragon leap, and all of a sudden, boom, it popped him right out. So, and I do that a lot. Once I know what vicinity they're in and what range I can get, even on a Magicka user, I'll use certain abilities that, cannot be avoided. So, just a little bit of PvP advice, guys, coming up. And of course, let's see how many points I got out of that whole. It should be two, one. My enlightenment wore off, but if I was enlightened, I would have got two. So it makes sense. But if you have any questions or comments, post below. I do want to thank everybody for watching. Sorry, kind of a little tired. Just rough morning, I guess. But thank you guys. I always appreciate it. I like coming on here. I love proving the builds, showing what I can do, what you can do, potentially. And I appreciate all my viewers every day of the week. You guys are the best. You guys really are. My real viewers are the best. And I learn from you guys so much. So once again, always thank you and have a nice day.